pessimist might view this vacant mall space as half empty. But Torrance Art Museum director and head curator Max Presnell sees it as half full. It's an opportunity to turn his museum inside out.
We start seeing how the museum can become more than just the building it's in and start engaging further out in different kind of programs and exhibitions. So we wanted to do something with public art.
After being closed for 18 months, the COVID-19 pandemic provided perfect timing for the museum to execute a long-pondered concept borrowed from the Munster Sculpture Project. The popular exhibition features sculptures in various outdoor and public spaces in the town of Munster, Germany.
So we dusted it off, started looking at new artists. We pulled the whole thing together in slightly less than a year. These things normally take 2 to 3 years, so we put a lot of effort into it.
From now until August 28th, Torrance Art Museum's version, called Ultra, features a collection of more than 20 installations from among Southern California's most noted contemporary artists. The self-guided tour begins by picking up a guide at the Torrance Art Museum or the Discover Torrance Visitor Center at Del Amo Fashion Center. The mall features 8 installations. They include Jeff Frost's California on Fire. The thought-provoking video spotlights footage from California's wildfires. Next door to Dick's Sporting Goods, artist Josh Belizzo displays 2 playful pieces done in marble, Banana Splits and Groucho Nose. Long Beach artist Reed Van Brushut drew inspiration for the paper bags from Bloomingdale's iconic bag with a hint of social commentary.
Kind of parody on that very famous bag that Massimo Vignelli designed called the Little Brown Bag. This has a lot to do with like big box retailers and kind of the end of the era, you know, as more shops close down and kind of what are we doing with these spaces. And it's kind of symbolic of like all these things that we purchase as consumers, you know, oftentimes we don't even need them.
Many of the exhibits are designed to be interactive, like this one called Genus Loci at Del Amo Mall, which captures your image as you're walking by and transposes it onto the screen. Outdoor venue El Prado Park features one of 2 Abram Santa Cruz's electric dandelions, which light up after dark. And these socially conscious banners, called Homes of the Brave by Richard Ancrom, drape the landscape just outside the Torrance Art Museum, known as TAM.
Most of the work does have a slight edge of critique in there, which is kind of interesting. But there's also a lot of humor and play with a lot of the works, even with that. It's kind of a two-pronged, a kind of political approach and an art approach to some of those kind of more cutting edge or problematic social fields.
It gets people to like all corners of the city. So not only are they seeing fabulous art, they are also exploring the city while they're out there. Even people who live here may not have been to all the places. So while they're out enjoying this art in the beautiful sunshine and fresh air, they're learning about our city as well.
The Torrance Art Museum hosted a launch event for Ultra, which featured performance artists and interactive experiences, such as Zach Monday's Molt, which guided blindfolded visitors through a rope labyrinth.
I heard voices, and when you reorient, you can feel how where the space is, it's shifting from the left to the right.
This has been a tough year for everybody, and everybody's been so cooped up. And now to be able to get out and see something that might will put a smile on your face or make you think about something other than what we've all been thinking about in these past months.
Whether you choose to passively engage or fully immerse yourself in the artwork, Ultra is sure to spark the imagination and engage the senses. From Torrance Art Museum, Colleen Farrell.